What is going on, guys? It is Marksman here, and I have your daily dose of Search and Destroy. And today I got a gameplay for you on Standoff using the PDW. This is the new PDW after the update. I'm using three attachments on it, which would be the grip, long barrel, and I believe I'm using stock as well. So no quick draw, but I still like the stock on it. And the reason I like stock is because I feel when you are strafing, it lowers the recoil of the weapons you are strafing with. So right there is a good reason not to use shock charges. Stuns last longer, ladies and gentlemen. Do not ever throw shock charges at me, you fucker. Okay. Anyways, the MLG COD Championships, or whatever, not MLG, I'm sorry, the Call of Duty Championships that was hosted by Microsoft and Treyarch are now over. I hope you guys were watching it. You had a lot of fun. Hope you enjoyed it. There were some absolutely disgusting games. I cannot believe Envy beat Fariko on a hard point game. That was insane. Like, after they lost to Search and Destroy, everyone was like, it's fucking over. It's over. Fariko doesn't lose hardpoint. They're really good at hardpoint. And then Envy, out of nowhere, just comes out and cannons the hardpoint on raid. And I honestly, for a second, with like 25 seconds left in the game, I thought they were going to lose because Envy dropped an airstrike, or dropped not an airstrike, a Hellstorm missile. And it was the last hill on raid is in the center of raid. And the tree is a bunker, unfortunately. I thought they were going to lose because they dropped a Hellstorm or two Hellstorms on that base, except all it did was hit the tree. And I was thinking, like, in my head, how pissed would you would be if you as a team lost 200 grand because Treyarch decided to make trees fucking bunkers. Like, honest to God, I would be so furious. And I don't know if anyone said anything about it, but it's like, dude, you guys could have lost because the tree was invincible. It's just something to think about. I mean, like, wow. And I don't know if Treyarch was like watching it. They had people there and they were watching, but I mean, I don't know if they noticed that or why they thought trees should be invincible, but I don't know if they're going to change anything about it. That could have been a really, really, I mean, how horrible would that be if someone lost 200K over a tree being invincible? That's ridiculous, right? But Envy did clutch it out. They clutched out the hardpoint raid. They played Fariko then on Search and Destroy Meltdown, which I still feel is a fucking horrible Search and Destroy map, competitive or public. It's just bad. It's defense-oriented. It's very easy to play defense on that map and win, especially in publics, or especially in competitive, because all the competitive guys are used to, like, you know, sitting back and trying to wait it out and camp. I call it camping, but, you know, money's on the line, so I think in that way it's playing, you know, smart. In publics, I like to run around as fast as I can with an SMG, so Meltdown is kind of more even in that rate. But in competitive, I think defense has, you know, an 80% chance to win the round. And if you go back and watch the games, defense won. Mostly anytime the person was on defense or the team was on defense, they'd win. So it's just my opinion that I think, you know, Meltdown shouldn't be in the rotation for that, but obviously that's not the case. Again, I'm sure some people don't like Cargo Search and Destroy. I love Cargo Search and Destroy. Just me. Anywho, big congratulations to Fariko Impact for taking the win. So Parasite, Miracles, Killa, and Karma, congratulations, guys. And Brainiac, who's the team owner of Fariko. I'm sorry about that. I haven't met Brainiac before. Seems like a chill dude. Then again, I haven't met Parasite or Miracles. But I know Killa and Karma, both fucking awesome dudes. So I'm so glad that they got the win at least. Awesome games. I couldn't have asked for more, really, in the championships. They were sick. Had some good COD casting going down by Fwiz and Benson. So it was all around a really good tournament, in my opinion. Now, I do think that the hardest thing about this now is going to be, like, Microsoft and Treyarch to keep this tradition going. You know, COD XP to the Call of Duty World Championships. Are they going to be able to continue this annual competition for this $1 million tournament in every game, every year? Will Treyarch bounce out and Infinity Ward come in with Microsoft? And, I mean, will they switch out like that? Or, like, what will happen next year, you know? That's what I'm kind of thinking, like, well, they did it two times now. They're almost obligated to hold a $1 million tournament every time. Or people will expect it at least, right? So I'm curious. I'm curious what will happen. You know, maybe they'll hold a $1 million tournament for Call of Duty Modern Warfare 4. Or, you know, they're going to have to change the name of that eventually, right? Like, you can't just keep going up in numbers. It just kind of gets boring, like. They're going to change the name of it. I wonder what they're going to change it to, though. Like, what should we call it? Call of Duty Modern Warfare Elite. Ooh, yeah, right there. That goes with their COD Elite. Works hand in hand. Hand in hand, baby. Anyways, that about wraps up the gameplay. 15-0 with the PDW. So I hope this has shown you that you can still use the PDW. It's not the best gun anymore, but it is still pretty good. You just got to give it some practice. You might have to use the triple attachment. I found it to be pretty helpful once I did that. So I'm hoping you give it a shot at least. If you did like it before, you should still like it. But thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Comment, rate, and subscribe if you'd like. If not, no worries. I will still love you. Almost messed that up. And as always, make sure to keep on gaming.
Gentlemen.